Plow, Dancing with a Thief, Dancing with a Thief, Jan Schlau.
Contest chair, fellow Toastmasters and guests, I know someone who did allow a thief into their home. They were told that this shady character lacked moral conviction and could possibly rob them of all they held dear. Yet they still allowed them to eat at their table, watch TV with their family, and even sleep under their roof. Now, after a few days, their family began to notice some changes. They grew uncomfortable. So the homeowner asked the thief to leave, but he said no, and so he stayed. Some more time passed, and then the homeowner began to notice some items from their home were missing. The lamp from the corner that gave off such great light was no longer there. The family photo that always made them smile was missing from the wall. And the book they read their little one before bed was nowhere to be found. The homeowner realized that they had made a terrible mistake and again asked the thief to leave, but this time used a firm voice and shook their finger. The thief just smiled and calmly said, "No, I like it here. I think I might stay." Day after day, they danced this dance, and day after day, the homeowner noticed more and more items missing. And day after day, the thief refused to leave. Now, I'm sure you are wondering why they did not just lock their doors, right? Because that's what we all would have done. We take care to lock up what's important to us. So no one here would have allowed that thief into their homes. Right? Well, what if we changed the narrative slightly and replaced a few of the key words? What if we called the thief by a different name? Anger, anxiety, worry, envy, even insecurity. And what if it was not a home that they were allowed into, but a person's head, heart, and soul? What if it was not a physical lamp that was stolen, but indeed the light that lit up the darkest corners of your mind? What if you stole the joy that you once felt when you looked at your family photos, or wore you down to the point where you didn't have enough energy to read a bedtime story to your little one? If you stole your confidence, you're left wondering when the last time you even smiled was. I myself struggle with anxiety and insecurity, and every day I fight with my mind, my thief. And with every dance we dance, and every time I come out on top, I grow a wee bit stronger. Now, I've battled with this my whole life, and for most of my life I was losing. I just faked a smile. Played the role society wanted me to play, because, let's be honest, most people don't want to hear how you're really doing. Most people are just exchanging pleasantries as a way to make small talk. And if I'm being really honest here tonight, growing up with a mother who suffered from mental illness, I spent most of my life fighting to prove I had complete and utter control of my own mind and thoughts. So I held on so tight until my knuckles turned white and I could hold on no longer. And I watched as the items from my home slowly were being stolen from me. And I felt broken, battered, and beaten. And then one day, about 8 years ago, I had a major anxiety attack in front of another person. Sitting in the garage of my new house, surrounded by boxes of my things and memories from my past. My eyes went blurry, and my mind began to race at a pace that even a cheetah would envy. And my breath grew short. And as I sat there rocking, I finally realized that I did not have control, and I needed help. That was the first time I ever told anyone what was going on inside my mind. It was my now husband who had the misfortune of watching me go from a woman to a puddle in a matter of minutes, and it was him who told me that it is okay to not be okay. That was the beginning of me asking my thief to leave my home, and we have been dancing the dance ever since. When we leave our homes, we lock our doors and windows. We lock our cars up when we get out. We even lock up our bikes. We take care to protect our possessions, the things that are important to us. We would never dream about making it easy for someone to walk into our homes and take what they did not earn or value. I am learning to take the same care to protect myself. My mind, body, and soul are worth locking up safely from known thieves. Why would I put any less value on myself than I would on a flat screen TV or laptop? Somewhere along the way, I forgot how valuable I truly am. Have you forgotten how valuable you are too? Have you allowed a thief into your home after all? What name does he go by? Have you forgotten that you too are worth protecting? Now, I still do have a thief living in my home, but I am happy to say that he sleeps on the front porch now. Mm-hmm. And with every dance we dance, he is moving farther and farther away from my front door. 100%.